Welcome back to my channel. It's Amanda here as always, and today I'm going to show you guys this taupey, smoky look that I did yesterday for my homecoming dance. I know homecoming is over for most people, or not most people, but some people, but I know a lot of people still have homecomings to go to, so maybe you'll get some ideas from this, or you can use this for any other formal occasion. It is a lot limited to homecoming. My camera is dying as I'm filming this intro, so let's go ahead and get started. Also, I apologize in advance for the lighting. I started filming too late in the day because I didn't have time and the sun was setting, so the light you're seeing right now is actually artificial. It's from a ceiling fan and from my lamp because that is all I have, but a good part of this was filmed in natural daylight, so it looks better. That's why this doesn't look as blended. I hope you guys still enjoyed, and if you'd like to recreate this look, you know, let me know. Tell me about it. Okay, so I'm going to be starting off with the face. I obviously have some redness going on, in case you didn't notice. I'm actually a little bit sunburned. I'm going to start off with the Origins Original Skin Renewal Serum. I've been using this lately just to do stuff. I don't know. It's good for your skin, apparently. So I'm going to use that before my primer kind of as a moisturizer, but also just to kind of get those benefits going in my skin, especially since I'm sunburned. I need a little help rejuvenating. My breakout's kind of going away. That's better. I mean, I'm still like broken out, but those are kind of things that are like healing. Anyway, y'all don't care. But last week I was so broken out, but I failed a makeup video anyway, but I filmed the entire thing out of focus. That's the only thing I don't like about the camera that I'm using, which is the EOS Rebel T3i, whatever. Yeah, that's it. And it's great, it takes really good quality stuff, but it can't autofocus while filming. Like, I looked it up, it apparently can't do that. Unless I'm terribly wrong, which would be great. Prove me wrong, please. But yeah, so if I'm not in the exact right spot while I'm filming, that means the entire video is gonna be out of focus, which is really annoying because I can't tell, like, looking at the viewfinder, because my vision isn't that great, you know, so. I can't tell. So then I'll upload it to iMovie and then see all the things out of focus, and I'm like... Next, to combat redness, I'm using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I've had the mini one for a while, but I just got the full size. The mini one lasted me a long time. And I do have some redness, and this helps with that. I prefer this kind of primer to, like, a redness correcting concealer, because it kind of blends into the skin to get rid of redness instead of a concealer which like sits on the skin. And you know, it can kind of create another layer of makeup, which is just another layer that can get cakey. Let's see. Opening up the NARS foundation. I didn't want to do a full first impression video on this like by itself because I feel like everyone else has done that. And you know, like I'm expecting to love it. Like I swatched it on my hand and I was like, oh, this shade's nice. Oh shoot, I don't know if this is a pump or not. Okay, this is a huge bottle. Like, it's a big, heavy bottle of foundation. Like, this will last me a long time. Hopefully. It better. So, I think you have to buy the pump separately with NARS foundations, which is okay. Because I end up just putting it all on the back of my hand anyway. Oh, it has this thing. It has a stick. I didn't realize that. That's actually okay. Cool. So, I'll put that. It looks really yellow. Okay. So, I'm going to get a little bit of this. And then using a damp beauty blender, like always. Oh. When I swatched it on my hand, it was really, really light. My hand is tanner than my face, though. But my logic was, it looks the same as when I swatched my concealer by NARS in the lightest shade on the back of my hand, which is also tan. So that may not have been the best logic, but I'm pretty sure I have some yellow undertones anyway, so I'm pretty sure when I blend this out, it'll be fine. But we'll see. I can't see. I have to like set my mirror down because like when I'm blending and holding it, like shaking around, I'm like, ah. Like, I don't know. The shade, yeah, the shade is really weirdly yellow. I don't know if it's showing up more yellow because of my sunburned skin or not, but that's really yellow. NARS, who did you think would be that yellow? Or maybe it's just the light I'm in. I don't know if it's coming up that yellow on camera. Like, I'm not unhappy with it. Like, it looks really good when I blend it out. It just looks yellow. I don't know what I'm gonna do about that. What I'm going to do now is actually put a BB cream on top because I still want that, like, really radiant, for lack of a better word, sparkliness Because my BB cream has lots of sparkles in it, so it gives you like an all-over glow. Oh, sorry, I just touched my face. I realized the texture is really like nice. Like it's really velvety, and that's not just from the primer. Like this is from that foundation. So let me blend a little bit more on my forehead because that's where I tend to get a little cakey. This is the, what is it? Shimmering BB cream by The Face Shop. I usually don't put on like more than one skin product. This is really excessive, but it was homecoming. I was like, you know what? Like if I wanted this luminousness that the BB cream gives on a daily, I would just wear the BB cream. But I needed that full coverage because I feel like smoky eyes without full coverage look strange. I don't know, like it takes away from the look. Anyway, oomph. And while the foundation is not, I don't know, it says luminous, it's not exactly like luminous like I'm used to, but I'm spoiled because I buy all these like super dewy, like Korean face makeup products. I don't know. A lot of the Korean makeup I have that's for skin is especially aimed at getting that like super shiny dewy look, which I love. Not everyone loves, which is fine, but I love that. So then what other companies may say is luminous, I'm like, but it's not chock full of glitter. Like my BB cream is. It's literally like sparkly. That's why it's so luminous. And I love that. Yeah, the sun's setting. I was out for most of the afternoon and I got back at like 5 o'clock. I was like, shoot, the sun's setting. And then of course, I couldn't find the little SD card reader that had my only like SD card in it. Or it has both of them, but I couldn't find it, so. I was like, where's my SD card? I can't record without an SD card. It was stressful. Stressful, man. All right, I'm still blending. So now I am going to take my NARS concealer. Oh look, they're matching. Anyway, I'm gonna take my NARS concealer. I think that night I used my IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer because it was more full coverage, but I don't want to go grab it because it's across the room. I've already run across the room twice. So I'm just going to make kind of a little mini triangle shape. I'm not doing like all the way out, but I find that if you have like really deep set under eyes like I do and you get those like slash marks in your face, when you get dark circles, it helps if you have something that's like on this part of the nose, like right underneath that slash, because it brings like, it brings that level of skin up to the level that's right underneath your eye. And so it helps take away the shadow from that under eye bag. Let's see, next I'm gonna do eyebrows. So I'm gonna take the spoolie from the end of my brow wiz and comb my eyebrows through. I actually did my eyebrows today, so when we zoom in for the eye look in just a minute, you'll actually be able to see, like, they're semi-clean. I, like, never do my eyebrows. It's because my eyebrows don't grow. Like, I kind of, when I was younger and I actually started plucking them, like, in 8th grade or whatever, they weren't even that bad. I just kind of did it once and was done with it. My brow pomade has dried out just a little bit. So I'm going to go in with, yeah. I'm going to get my Smashbox Primer Water. Just spray it over the top of that, just mist it. Just to wet the top. Wet the top. I find that that's more effective than using a like oil, because oil breaks down makeup, so it's gonna end up shortening the life of your product. Then I'm just taking a little cotton pad and kind of tapping the top, or like pressing it in, just to soak up any primer water that doesn't get absorbed. But I'm just re-wetting the top so it doesn't actually disturb the rest of the product. Just the very surface that I need. So it's kind of flattened it out too, just to get rid of all those little bumps from when, you know, when you start using your brow wiz or your brow pomade and it's super like crumbly. That was me until just a second ago when I rehydrated the bed. First, I'm going to use a base color though, because I did use a primer and things are going to get difficult to blend. So I'm using like only my Naked 2 brush for this because I can't find my two favorite makeup brushes. And it's making me sad, but I'll push through. Taking the color from the Semi Sweet Choco Bar palette by Too Faced, the color Coconut Cream, just as like a light nude, and placing it from the lid to the brow. I'm gonna take the color Nougat and
I just dropped all my makeup.
And brush that into my crease just to warm it up a little bit. So for my first or second crease color, I'm going to take the ColourPop Super Shock Eyeshadow in Bill. I think this is the favorite, this is my favorite that I've bought so far. Gosh, these are weird. I hate using this Naked brush in these eyeshadows because they're like a super creamy consistency, but they're still powders, but they're creamy, and I'm like taking this kind of rough, dense brush and just like decimating it, but it's okay. And I'm kind of blending it onto the lid, not totally. Like I'm blending it out from the crease and like from the bottom and the top. Words aren't making sense. It goes down and it goes up. But I'm not entirely coating the lid. Like I'm leaving a little space by my lash line. Because I don't want solid color, I just want to kind of blend it. Oh shoot, I meant to zoom you guys in for this. Hang on. I am sorry in advance if the lighting is like yellow or gross, because I am using a desk lamp. Now I'm going to take the color Party Time to put that into my crease. It's, the color is very similar to Bill. So I'm actually gonna use a flat brush to do this because I feel like I need a little bit more precision. I will blend it out, but I need it in like a concentrated area on the crease. Ow, this brush is so hard. All right, and you see how, you know, whenever I do my crease, it kind of gets enveloped by my eyelids. Like you see it and then you don't see it. So I'm just gonna apply a little bit more of it on the upper part of my crease. But with my eye open, just right out here. A lot of people, I have this rule, like you don't apply eyeshadow on that part of your eye, like above your crease. I'm saying like a lot today too, I'm sorry. But it just, sometimes it has to happen. Like if you're like me and you have hooded eyelids, I just have a lot of skin up in my eye area. So whenever I do anything there, it just kind of gets lost. Next, I'm going to take a Milani eyeshadow, what's it called? Milani Bella Eyes Gel Powder Eyeshadow, that's a lot, in Satin White, just the Milani eyeshadow. And just highlight under my brow. This flat brush has a lot of other stuff on it, and I totally got that in my eyebrow. And I'm going to take the ColourPop eyeshadow in Cricket. Aw, it's my dog's name. That's the dog y'all see in my videos. I don't know if you know me, you know my dog's name is Cricket. I have two. And I'm gonna put this all over the lid. Anyway, yeah, that's the dog that sits on my bed in my videos and like sleeps all the time. She's always sleeping on my bed. So I don't wanna move her when she's recording. Or when I'm recording, she doesn't record. Go subscribe to my dog on YouTube. I'm going to take a small Real Techniques smudge brush and basically do the same thing to my lower lash. Oh, you can't see. You can't tell, but this is a really unnatural way for me to hold my head. But I've got to do it. I'm going to take my brand new Lights Camera Flashes mascara. Well, this isn't the first time I've used it. I use that mascara like faithfully. This is the only mascara I think I've purchased more than like twice. Yes. Cause I always switch. I'll use it once and get bored of it. But, ooh. This thing is so good. Anyway, in case you couldn't tell, I'm applying mascara. I don't think I need to narrate that part, but whatever. Thanks, pollen. Oh, I did that. I was distracted by my hatred for pollen. That never happens, man. Anyway, this may bother some people, but I'm gonna leave that there because this is a life lesson. Whenever you do that, let it dry because wet mascara smudges and dry mascara flakes. So dry mascara is gonna be easier to get off without like totally ruining your foundation. So this is the finished eye look. Oh goodness. It looks so good in real life. Like it looks bomb, but it looks floppy on camera. I am going to set just a little bit under my eyes. I set more yesterday because I used my IT Cosmetics concealer, I think. And that's a thicker, high coverage concealer that needs to be set. But I'm just taking a little bit of my powder on my beauty blender. Oh shoot, that's what I should have gotten at Sephora. I need a new beauty blender, do y'all see this?
It is so torn up.
It's clean. Well, it's not clean. I wash it regularly. Like, it doesn't have stuff growing in it yet. But it is torn up. Since I'm using a ColourPop liquid matte lipstick, they recommend that you exfoliate. And I exfoliate my lips every day anyway. I just take a wet towel and kind of rub it over my lips just to get rid of any, like, dead skin. I'm going to use the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in the color Trap, which is a kind of taupey grayish color. I'm going to use a flat brush to create a line. And I'm just going to line my lips with it. Just kind of outline them, because the wand is kind of hard to get a clean line with. My camera's about to die. I went ahead and applied it off camera, but there's no secret to it. I just use a flat brush to kind of create that line, and then I filled it in. I think the key to working with these ColourPop lippies in general is using thin layers, because if you use thick layers, when it dries, it's going to get, like, gross and crack, and I think thin layers are more pliable, and they'll move with your lips a little bit better. I don't know if that's an actual rule, but it is what I have found works. If you just layer it and layer it on, it's just going to get real thick, and it's not going to want to move with your lips, and it's just going to push together and crack. And I also contoured off camera. Wait. Okay, the low battery thing just popped up. It was gone for a minute. I just contoured my cheekbones with my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour kit. I just used a mixture of this shade and this shade. Normally, I don't use these because they tend to be a little bit too orange for my skin tone. But I went a little heavier with it because I knew it was going to be dark, obviously, at homecoming. And I still wanted people to see my cheekbones. So I'm going to highlight. I'm actually just going to highlight on top of my cheekbones, I think, yeah. And I'm using my Tony Moly Crystal Marble Highlighter in Glow Gold. And I'm taking the lighter part, because it's a duo right here, if y'all can see. And I'm just gonna highlight my cheekbones, because I kinda want that to be the focus. I feel like my contour looks a little bit splotchy. So I'm just taking a fluffy brush, which actually has some blush left on it, and blend that. But I'm not going to apply any blush because I like how the cool contour kind of matches up with the rest of this. My camera's about to die. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave a like. And if you are not already and would like to be, subscribed to my channel so you can keep up with what I am posting. I love you guys so much and I hope you have a great day. Bye! But I don't